Hi everybody, Simona here from Vector Twist. Day 4 of our series, 12 Days of Christmas, and today we're going to be working with similar colors. Sometimes when you work on an artwork, you have tons of elements, and you color away, set everything up, and you think you are almost finished, you realize you have some color discrepancies. Maybe you picked a different color than you originally wanted, or you have to change a color, or you realize you have similar colors and you actually need to all unify them. And I would like to show you how you can do that really fast. So in this example, we have tons of ornaments, mostly in green and red. Now if you look closely, you can see that some of the greens don't match. Now if you wanted to have a unified green, for example, this ornament has a light green, but the stripes in here have a light green and a dark green. What if you wanted to change the dark green to match the light green? Or vice versa. Now just to select a few of those wouldn't be a problem. You would just select them and then switch to the proper color. What if you notice that you also have some smaller elements hidden somewhere? They might not stand out to you right away. For example, you can see that these circles have the dark color applied as well. Now you could go over all of your artwork and find the darker green, select them one by one and switch the color. But there's a much easier way. So I'm going just to select the shape. You can see that we have a fill and a stroke. And I know I just want to change the fill color. So all we have to do is go up to select, same, and choose fill color. And watch what happens. Now it went through all of the shapes on the artboard and found that exact same green, highlighted it for me, and now I can change it. And then I can go up into the swatches panel and choose my lighter green. Now, in case I even have another color in here that doesn't match the lighter green, for example, when you look at the circles, they still have a different kind of color. It wasn't the darker green, it's another kind of green. I can do the same thing, just select the shape, go back to select, same, and select same fill color, and then I'm going to apply the color that I want. Now, it might be quite obvious that the color was different here, but I can tell you that this artwork has reds that I don't want. And it's this particular bright red that I want to find and change. I'm going to click the shape, go up to select, same, and then choose fill color. As you can see, it finds it in all kinds of places. I don't even have to look really hard. Illustrator will just find it for me. And then I'm going to change this particular bright red into a darker red. Now this doesn't just work with the fill, it also works with the stroke. For example, if I select this stroke here, it's a dark red, and I would like to change all of the strokes I have in my artwork into an orange. I can do the same thing by going to select, same, and instead of fill color, I choose stroke color. And it will find all of them, and then I can change them. So I can change them from a red into an orange. But that's not all. I can also search by stroke weight. If I select this shape here, you can see that my stroke is set to 0.5, but the shape above, the stroke is set to 1 point. Now I would like to have everything unified, so I want to find each element that only has 0.5 in stroke setting and change that. So I'm going to select the shape, go back to select, same, and then I'm going to choose stroke weight. Now on the artboard you can see that we found all of the strokes that only have 0.5 points in stroke. And then we can change them to be 1 point. This can really be helpful if you have quite complicated artwork with lots of shapes, strokes, colors, and sometimes you have to find a particular color, or you need to select all the blues and change them into a Pantone color, or you need to find that black that doesn't match. And then you can use the select, same, and search either by appearance, blend mode. You can even choose fill and stroke, fill color, opacity, stroke color, stroke weight, and so forth. If you had symbols on here or graphic styles, you could search by that as well. And this is it. This tool really helps me often to find colors that don't match that I need to change. And hopefully you will use this tool as well, just to make sure that you're not spending hours on selecting all of your blue shapes in your intricate artwork. If you liked it, please leave a comment below. And do not forget to subscribe to the channel here. And at the same time, don't forget to head over to vectortwist.com and check out more tutorials and articles on the blog. And I'll see you tomorrow with our next tip, so stay tuned.